Hello students, we were dealing with physiological disorders in mango, that is mango malformation. Now it is, malformation is widely prevalent in northern India, particularly in the states of Punjab, Delhi and western Uttar Pradesh, where more than 50% of the trees suffer from this malady. The causes of disease, that is complexity of the disorder, is attributed to cultural practices, nutritional, too many factors like mites, fungal, viral and hormonal imbalance, etc. The symptoms of this malformation is that three types of symptoms, that is bunchy top phase, floral malformation and vegetative malformation. In bunchy top phase, in nursery, bunching of thick small shoots bearing small rudimentary leaves, shoots remain short and stunted, giving to bunchy top appearance. In vegetative malformation, excessive vegetative branches of limited growth in seedlings, they are swollen with short internodes, forming bunches of various size on the top of the seedlings, shows bunchy top appearance. The malformation of inflorescence remain unproductive and are characterized by compact mass of male flowers, greenish in color and stunted in growth. Secondary branches are transformed into number of small leaves, giving witch's broom appearance. Now for control, these exact cause and control of the malady is yet to be established. Use of disease-free planting material. This is the plant should be destroyed. Incidence induced by spraying 100 to 200 ppm NEA during October. Pruning of diseased parts with basal 15 to 20 cm apparently healthy portions, followed by spraying of carbendazim 0.1%. Now second is alternate, and second problem or malady in mango cultivation, alternate bearing or biennial bearing. Refers to the heavy fruiting in 1 year, that means on year, and followed by less or no fruiting in the following year, that is off year. The factors related to this disorder are, problem is, environmental factors, age and size of the shoot, crop load, hormonal control, carbon nitrogen ratio, and varietal influence. Now control measures advised are deblossoming and thinning of fruits, smudging, use of plant growth regulators, pruning, application of potassium nitrate, and growing regular bearing varieties in the orchard. Now fruit drop, this is also a major problem in mango. Despite high fruit set initially, the ultimate retention is quite low in mango. The intensity of fruit drop varies from variety to variety. The fruit drop is more or less continuous process and can be classified into three groups: pinhead drop, post-setting drop, and May month drop. The fruit drop in the first two groups are insignificant compared to the third group, which affects the final yield significantly and needs more attention. The major factors in relation are contributing the fruit drop are embryo abortion, climatic factors, disturbed water relation, lack of nutrition, diseases, pest and hormonal imbalances. Now for control of fruit drop, the foliar application of Allery, that is B9 at the rate of 100 ppm or naphthalene acetic acid 20 ppm at P stage. Among the commercial grown varieties, Langra is the most susceptible to fruit drop, while Dasheri is least susceptible to this problem. Now maturity, fruits generally ripe within 95 to 115 days after flowering. Fruit generally required, that is 95 to 115 days to mature after flowering. Building up shoulders, now these are the maturity indices or signs of maturity. Building up of shoulders and a slight depression near the stalk end. Color changes from dark green to pale green in fruits. Reddish blush develops on the fruit shoulders. Red blush develops on the fruit shoulders. When one or two ripe fruits fall from the plant, drop from the plant naturally. When the specific gravity of fruits ranges between 1.01 to 2, these are very important points, that is, these are the indices of maturity or signs of maturity. These are to be, they may be asked in the exam, that is, maturity days, slight depression at the stalk end, change of color of the fruits from dark green to pale green, red blush at shoulders, one or two ripe fruits fall naturally from the tree. Specific gravity, the fruits attains a specific gravity of about 1.01 to 2. Now harvesting, the harvesting in mango should be done. The harvesting in mango should be done in the morning hours, as the fruit should be collected in plastic trays and kept in shades. The fruit should not be allowed to fall on the ground as the injured fruits cause spoilage to other healthy fruits during packaging and storage. The fruits harvested with 8 to 10 millimeter long stalks appear better on ripening as undesired spots on skin caused by sap burn are prevented. Fruits harvested with 8 to 10 millimeter long stalks appear better on ripening as undesired spots on skins caused by sap burn are prevented. I will explain this in Marathi. आंब्याची फळांची काढणी करताना 8 ते 10 मिलीमीटर लांबीचा देठ ठेवून त्यांची काढणी करायची आणि ते व्यवस्थित पिकतील, व्यवस्थित पिकतील, रंग येईल, व्यवस्थित पिकतील. मात्र जर आपण देठ न ठेवता काढणी केली तर चिकामुळे त्या फळांवर स्पॉट्स येऊन चिकामुळे जखम होण्याची शक्यता असते आणि चिक उतू शकतो फळांवरती आणि त्यामुळे डाग पडू शकतात. त्यामुळं 10 मिलीमीटर लांबीचा देठ ठेवून आंब्याच्या फळांची काढणी करायची. फ्रूट्स हार्वेस्टेड बाय स्टिक आर इंज्युअर्ड, ब्रिज्ड ड्यू टू इम्पॅक्ट रिझल्टिंग इन डिके, पुअर क्वालिटी अँड अट्रॅक्ट लो प्राईस. ट्रॅडिशनल मेथड्स कंज्यूम ए लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी. टू ओव्हरकम दीज प्रॉब्लेम्स अ सिम्पल लो कॉस्ट अँड पोर्टेबल मेजर मँगो हार्वेस्टिंग डिवाइस हॅज बीन डिझाईन्ड अँड डेव्हलप्ड बाय CISH लखनऊ. This saves time and protects fruits from mechanical damage due to impact. Now, yield in mango, yield varies with variety. The average mango yield is 8 tons per hectare, which varies with region. Andhra and Bihar are highly productive with this respect. High density planting increases the yield of mango. Now, regarding grading, if fruits are graded according to their size, weight, color and maturity, both the producer and consumer are benefited. That means grading is undertaken according to size, according to the weight of the fruit, according to the color and maturity of the fruit. It has been observed that bigger size fruit takes 2 days more time in ripening than the smaller ones. Hence, packaging of smaller fruits with larger ones should be avoided to achieve uniform ripening. This is very important. To achieve uniform ripening, smaller fruits are to be packed separately and bigger ones are also to be packed separately, because bigger size fruits mature takes more time as compared to the smaller ones. Hence, immature, overripe, damaged and diseased fruits should be discarded. Now, immature, overripe, damaged and diseased fruits should be discarded. If the export quality mangoes are categorized into 3 grades according to the fruit size. That means for export of mangoes, there are 3 categories or 3 grades, category 1, category 2, category 3. These categories are made according to the weight of the fruit weight. That is, category 1 contains 200 to 250 grams of fruits. Weights, the fruits that weighing 200 to 250 grams are categorized as category 1. Second category, the fruits weighing 251 to 300 grams are categorized in second category, and the fruits weighing 300 and 350 grams are categorized in the third category. Now, the mature green fruits can be kept at room temperature for about 4 to 10 days depending upon the variety. Shelf life of fruits could be extended by pre-cooling, chemical treatments and low temperature. Now, these are the 3 methods to increase the or extend the shelf life of mango fruits, that is by pre-cooling, chemical treatments and low temperature. The harvested fruits are pre-cooled at 10 to 12 degrees centigrade and then sorted at an appropriate temperature. The fruits could be stored for 3 to 4 weeks in good conditions at low temperatures. The problem of chilling injury at low temperature can be overcome by keeping the fruits in 0.5% ventilated polythene bags. The fruits of the Dasheri, Mallika and Amrapali should be stored at 12 degrees centigrade, whereas the fruits of Langda at 14 degrees centigrade and fruits of that of Chausa at 8 degrees centigrade with an humidity, relative humidity of about 85% to 90%. So, this is all about mango cultivation. Today we saw its botanical description, its importance, varieties, propagation, fertilizer requirement, irrigation, major diseases and pests, and physiological disorders or major limitations or problems in mango cultivation, that is mango malformation, biennial bearing, all these are major problems. Students should keep this in mind. And also harvesting, maturity, storage and grading. So this is all for mango cultivation. Today we will stop here. Thank you all students.